So we have finished yoga, four techniques, and I'll be just telling four techniques in mindfulness. So first of all, what is mindfulness? What is mindfulness for your thought? What do you think it is? Mindfulness is at this present time what you are doing. You are just thinking what is happening without judging whether it is good or bad. Okay? Now you have come for a yoga session. So this is going on and your mind is just thinking, minding on it. That I have come today to do yoga. So mindfulness means paying attention in a particular way, on purpose in the present moment and non-judgmentally. Okay? And it is like heartfulness, mindfulness. So we had a program here, Dean Madam had arranged, and we had a program for mindfulness. So it is a capacity that everyone has for getting awareness of whatever you do. By cultivating mindfulness, the participants will be able to learn to respond to challenges with awareness that promotes calmness, stability in mind, and finding more effective way with which they can approach difficulties of day-to-day life. Mindfulness is the energy of attention which allows us to become fully alive in each moment. Just like that, you should not do anything. Everything, whatever you do, you have to know why I am doing this. Now, if a friend is going to talk something bad or something against you, you should not respond immediately. You have to, that is mindfulness. You should just think why she has talked like that. Immediately, you should not get angry and respond. How can you scold this? How can you tell these words to me? You should give some time. First, mind what is happening. You should stand out of that scene and think if someone is there, what will be the situation? Why she has told that? What is the problem with her? She might have got some other problem and she would have put it on you. So you should not react immediately. You should be calm and mind your words or mind your action before you do. At home, if something is happening, like you are going out of the house with your friend, but you have told your mother that you are going the day before. But on that day, when you are going, you have not told her when you just went out of the house. So she is asking, why you didn't inform me? Then you are telling her, no, you were taking bath and my friend is already there. But you can give a phone call or send a message, isn't it? So when you come home, she started to shout at you. See, your behavior is not good and everything. So immediately you should not respond telling and shouting at her back. Okay? You should think the situation when you are a mother, or you should just wait what she's expecting. What is she expecting? She's not thinking anything bad of you. She's very, what to tell? She's the caretaker. Anything to you, she'll be the worst person to be affected than any other person in the world. Okay? So she wants your safety, isn't it? She doesn't want you don't go here, or she's not hindering your happiness. But what you should tell at that time, you should not fight with her. You should just tell, yes, sorry, I should have informed you. I will not do it again. Okay? So this mindfulness plays a vital part in your day-to-day life. So this mindfulness, I'm going to tell only four techniques which will help you to do this. Okay? It is similar to yoga, but in yoga, you have instruction. Lie down, do this, do that. In this, it is not like that. You just allow all the thoughts to go inside your mind and just see what is happening. Even if you are very tensed, now exams are coming, you have not studied. So you just sit down and just think the exams are coming. So just if you get worked up, will you be able to do anything? So you analyze the tension. What is the tension going in my mind? So what can I do for that? Just by telling I have not done and getting worked up, will it give any solution for your problem? So this is mindfulness. Analyzing yourself, and doing something constructive at that moment. So today morning I was just telling, you just keep the flowers here. So that small work, we are just keeping it. Instead of that, you have a stem and it is having a direction, I told you. So if you keep it correctly in the direction of that stem, it will not fall. Okay? So very small things. Similarly, when you become a doctor, you are going for a theater for a surgery, something is happening outside or personally something you are affected, you should not go with that inside the theater. You are responsible for the other person's life. That is why this mindfulness is very important. Before entering the theater, you just sit down, analyze what has happened. So this we will come and solve the problem. But now, I am a doctor, I am going to take care of a patient. So you should first analyze, relax yourself, then go inside. Okay, everything. Similarly, when you go for a viva, you just go relaxed. Don't think I don't know this. You just tell your mind, whatever I know, I will answer. First keep your mindset like that. Immediately do, I don't know. Then when the examiner asks something, you will not know. But if you keep yourself calm, at least the thoughts will make you to recollect what you studied. You'll be able to tell. First calm yourself. That is why the sessions are being conducted and it will really help each one of you. So now we'll do four techniques. What are the four techniques? One is breathing. You concentrate on your breathing. We saw that. But this is a little different. And eating, mindful eating. Second technique is mindful eating, mindful movement of your body. Then what you did previously, the body scanning. You lie down and you scan your whole body. You lie, this Sarvangasana, like Sarvangasana. You are really very tired, you are not able to do anything, but suddenly you get a patient. I have experienced that many times. I'll be so tired, I am not well or something, I'll be just very tired, I'll not be able to move my hands. But suddenly I'll be having a patient for a cesarean section. I am in charge, the patient has come. It is having confidence in me, telling if I go to this doctor, she will take care of me. So I have been checking her every month. The final outcome, I must give a baby to her safely, isn't it? So at that juncture, I am not able to get up. So, but the Sarvangasana and all this, you just lie down, even if you are not well, you want to perform something. You lie down straight, do a body scan. You relax as we did. You relax your toes, relax your ankle joint, till the four legs. Just think what are there. The cells are there, the veins, the arteries, the nerves. Make all the cells and the arteries, muscles to relax. So you relax from your toe to your head. Go to the brain, the axons and dendrites. You can talk to them. That is mindful. You can talk to the whole, every part of your cell you can talk. You relax the whole system, then you ask for energy. Immediately you will get. You will not believe I went and I took the baby. Actually, I had arranged another one doctor because I was not well. But she was not confident enough. So no other go, I had to go. It is just because I had all these steps with me. So definitely this will help you in your career. And each one of you should practice this. Very simple things. Okay? Now we'll go with the techniques. Okay, first technique, you can just sit, you breathe, as we had a previous class, you breathe, normally you sit straight, breathe in, breathe out, now concentrate on your respiration, what is happening. How the air is flowing into the trachea, through the lungs, right lobe, left lobe, the bronchioles, the alveoli. It is filling the empty space, like how the air inside the balloon goes. This is naturally God is giving the air for this lungs. Now, you keep your hand on your one hand, right hand on your abdomen. Now you feel the breathing. This is mindfulness. You are going to think of your breath. What is really happening? You can feel the entry of the air. You breathe in and breathe out. You feel the entry of air inside your lungs when you are inhaling and exhaling. So this simple technique, you can do it early in the morning when you get up from the bed, when everything is quiet. You just sit in a corner. You can just first start with this. Breathe in, breathe out, feel the breath by keeping the palm on your abdomen. Okay? So this is the first technique. The second technique. Now, each one is having something in your hand. Yes, you are having something in your hand. You should think that you have not seen a thing like this at all, an eatable like this at all. You see what it is, how it is. It has become dry. There are wrinkles on that. And it has been dried for so many days, we don't know. It has been plucked and it has been made to dry. Now, you put it in your mouth and take a long time to taste this in your mouth. Yes, put it in your mouth. And slowly, don't immediately eat. Every minute, just taste that. Take a long time. So that you will know how the taste is so important. The tongue, when we eat, do we anytime mind what we are eating like this? Do we give importance for the thing what we take and eat? You are eating in the mess and you are telling this is not good, that is not good. The vegetables are not good. But just imagine the vegetables are made to grow for so many months or whatever it is. A person is taking care of that, pouring water, taking everything, and it is being brought for money. All the thing is happening just to give you some health. But are we looking that at like that? We don't look it at like that. It is going to give you some energy. Carrot is going to give you beta carotene, isn't it? So you don't talk with anything. You don't mind of anything. So mindful eating. The second technique is mindful eating. So whenever you eat, you analyze and you think that this is going to give you energy. Don't chumma eat like this and run away. Even if two or three mouthful you eat, you thank that nature for giving you this food and giving this energy. It has come down all the way just to feed you, isn't it? So mindful eating. This will definitely give you a lot of strength and make you feel that it is just for you. Okay? Second one is that. The third one is mindful movement. I will teach you the movements now. The fourth one is body scanning, which we have already done. You have to lie down. You feel. You see how your eyes, how is your nose, how is your mouth, how's your body, all working together just for you. You appreciate everything. And whatever anyone does, love and kindness and gratitude is very, very important. Now when they are taking classes, when someone is doing, you should thank them. Now we had a class of heartfulness. That person has just come for us. We are not paying him or nothing. He is coming just for the benefit of us. So you should learn that. That's a basic thing a human should do. Especially you're educated. Education is to make a good behaved person. It is not just to earn money or fame. It is to make the best human. And that is the purpose for what and all we are doing all this. So I want each one of you to follow. Even a person, something they do, you should thank them. So I expected you, I was going on telling you, unmute, tell a thanks. That word will be so, it will give them boost to go for the next session. They do the session whole day. They told you, no, 24 hours. We will be available. Anytime you call, we will meditate with you. So their concern is only for others. So we should thank them. Okay? First, you should all, my children, you should all learn that. And you should greet your teachers. Wherever you see your friends, if they tell something, you should give here. You just not go away. Because this time is very short. Once you finish the course, each one will be in a different place. Your memories will be how you behave with each other. So mindfulness is very important. And I want each one of you to really, a change must come inside each one of you. And it should come to my ear. You should wish all the teachers. Greet all your friends.